Alright, in this video I want to talk about some just basic integration problems. And by basic I mean you can either do them either by doing a little bit of algebra to your integrand, or you can just use a trig identity. No u-substitution, no partial fractions, nothing any crazier than that. So suppose we want to integrate 1 plus 2x minus 4x to the third, and all the problems I'm going to do right now are going to be indefinite integrals. The idea, when there's pluses or minuses in between your terms, you can basically integrate them a piece at a time. And typically, you won't really write it like this, most people will go ahead and just start integrating, but that's okay. Just for our first example, we'll rewrite it. Basically, it's kind of like you're distributing the integral sign to each piece. Well, the antiderivative of 1 is just x. Just like when you take derivatives, kind of the constant gets multiplied through at the end. When you find antiderivatives, the constant also gets multiplied through at the end. So the antiderivative of x to the first, remember you add 1 to the power, and also divide by that new power, minus 4x to the fourth over 4. Remember, with indefinite integrals you put this plus c on there. So I'm going to simplify it. My 2's will cancel. I'll have x plus x squared. My 4's will cancel. X to the fourth plus c. And there is my indefinite integral for this first problem. Okay, hopefully nothing too tricky. So obviously you need to know the basic formulas that go with these, but after that it's just a matter of applying those formulas. Suppose we have 3x minus 2 divided by square root of x. Okay, the first thing I usually do on these problems is the same thing as if I was going to take a derivative. Any radicals, I'll usually go ahead and rewrite those as powers. So my square root of x, I'll rewrite that as x to the 1/2. And at first sight, you know, you may think, well, I'll just take the antiderivative of each piece, but, you know, as a rule of thumb, use the same idea you would for taking derivatives. If you're going to take the derivative of 3x minus 2 over x to the 1/2, you wouldn't take the derivative of each piece individually. You'd have to use that more complicated quotient rule for taking derivatives. Well, for finding antiderivatives, it's the same way. You can't just find antiderivatives of each piece. But what you can do on this one is a little bit of algebra. You can rewrite it as 3x over x to the 1/2 minus 2 over x to the 1/2. And at this point, I'm going to simplify things down. So 3x divided by x to the 1/2. If I take x to the first, if I simplify x to the first over x to the 1/2, I'm left with x to the 1/2 in the numerator, minus 2 times x. If I bring the x to the 1/2 to the numerator, it'll become to the negative 1/2. And now this is in a suitable form for me to be able to integrate this. So again, the 3 comes along for the ride. X, if I add 1 to the 1/2, I'll get 3/2, and then I'll have to divide by 3/2. 2x, I'll add 1 to negative 1/2, I'll get positive 1/2. Again, I have to divide by 1/2, plus c. And if we simplify this, dividing by 3/2 is the same thing as multiplying by 2/3, so the 3's will actually cancel out. And I'll have 2x to the 3/2. Same thing, dividing by 1/2 is the same thing as multiplying by 2. So minus 4x to the 1/2 plus c. Whoops, ran out of room there. And again, there is your antiderivative. So if it doesn't look like something just very basic and fundamental, usually the first thing I try to do is to break it up using some algebra. In terms of all the integration techniques you'll learn, usually tweaking things with a little bit of algebra will probably be about the most straightforward way to go about things. All right, let's do another one here. Let's throw some trig into this one. Suppose we have sine of theta plus sine of theta tangent squared theta, and all of that being divided by secant squared theta. Okay, so maybe you could try the same trick as in the last problem. Maybe that would work, maybe not. But the trick to this one is recognizing, well, there's a sine of theta on top. You can actually factor that out. You'll have sine of theta, then 1 plus tangent squared theta, all being divided by secant squared theta. And the trick to doing a lot of problems involving trig is simply knowing your trig identities. So recall that sine squared of theta plus cosine squared of theta equals 1. This is one of the kind of the fundamental trig identities. If you divide everything by cosine squared theta, well, sine over cosine is tangent, but I have two of those, so I'm going to get tangent squared theta. Cosine squared over cosine squared is 1. 1 over cosine is secant, but again, it's being squared, so I'm going to get secant squared theta. Well, that's what I have right here in the top of my fraction, is a 1 plus tangent squared. So if you don't know your trig identities, you're going to run into really a ton of problems with integration, because a lot of times that's simply going to be the trick, is recognizing a trig identity. And if you don't see it, it may be really hard, if not impossible, to do. So 1 plus tangent squared, again, is the same thing as secant squared theta. I'll divide that by secant squared theta. Well, I can just cancel out my secant squared thetas, so that really all I'm integrating now is sine of theta. And the antiderivative of sine theta, not quite cosine theta, because remember the derivative of cosine theta is negative sine, so we need to put an extra minus sign in there, and then we'll tag on our plus c. So for something that looked like a pretty complicated integral at first, we end up with a relatively simple antiderivative. Let's see, let's maybe just do one more here since we're gonna run out of time. So suppose here you have, let's say, x plus 1 times x squared plus 3. Well, the same idea on this one. You can't just find the antiderivative of each piece. The first thing you have to do on this one is some algebra and to simply multiply it out. So x times x squared is x cubed, x times 3 is positive 3x, 1 times x squared is positive x squared, 1 times 3 is positive 3. If there's any like terms, combine them. Obviously there's none in here, so we can't really do much simplification on the integrand. And now we'll just integrate this thing. So the antiderivative of x to the third is x to the fourth over 4. The antiderivative of x to the first is x squared over 2. Again, we're just using this property of adding 1 and dividing by the new number. We'll get x to the third over 3. The antiderivative of 3 is simply 3x. And then we'll just tack on our plus c. And again, there's your antiderivative of the original problem. So again, I think this is something, a good rule to keep in the back of your mind. If it's not something very basic, just think to yourself, can I either do some algebra or trig identities? There's definitely other techniques for integrating things, and integration in general can become pretty tedious and pretty difficult. So usually doing some algebra or some trig identities is probably going to be the easiest thing to do if it does work. And if it doesn't work, you can quickly rule it out without wasting too much time. So, hope these videos help. Definitely feel free to jump over to my website for a ton of other calculus videos and other topics as well.